Today is the sixth session under crystallography. In the last session, that is session 5, we discussed about the elements of cemented cubic crystals. And we learned that there are totally 23 elements of symmetry in cubic system. Out of 23, 9 are planes of symmetry, of which 3 are rectangular and 6 are diagonal planes of symmetry, and 13 are axis of symmetry, and 1 is the center of symmetry. So totally, there are 23 elements of symmetry in cubic crystals. As we learned, cubic system is the center system and most symmetric system and contains the maximum number of symmetry elements. So with that background, today I shall move on to the laws of rational indices and Weis and Miller indices. So what is this law of rational indices? Crystals are three-dimensional systems. So the faces of these crystals are planes of the crystal intersect x, y and z axis at different lengths from the origin. So the intercepts made by the plane of the crystal along the crystallographic axis are either unit intercepts or some simple whole number multiples. So I repeat, the law of rational indices states that the intercepts made by the plane of a crystal along the three crystallographic axes are either unit intercepts or some simple whole number multiples of it. So let us, what is this? So x, y, z are the three crystallographic axes, and I have shown two planes, namely A, B, C plane and K, L, M planes intersecting x, y and z axes at different lengths. Now when we consider the plane ABC, I have shown this plane to have the intercepts along the x axis, y axis and z axis as A for ABC plane, the intercepts along x, y and z axis are shown as A, B, C. Look in the diagram. The distance from the origin to the point where the plane meets x axis, this distance is called as intercept. So, intercept made by this plane along any plane on the x axis is generally taken as A. Intercept made by the plane along the y axis is taken as B. Intercept made by the plane along the z axis is taken as C. And in this diagram, I consider A, B, C plane having unit intercepts between A, B and C, because the law of rational indices states that the intercepts made by the plane of a crystal are either unit intercepts or some simple whole number multiples of it. So in this crystal, in this diagram, for A, B, C, I have taken the intercepts as A, B, C. What does A, what do these ABs represent? 1A, 1B, 1B, that is unity. So for A, B, C, I have shown unit intercepts. Similarly, if you consider K, L, M plane, look at this K, L, M plane. So approximately I have taken the intercept made by this K, L, M plane among the x axis as 3A. Look here. This is A and this is almost 3 times A, and look at the intercept made by the plane A L and the y axis, I have taken it as 2B, and intercept made by this plane along z axis is taken as 2C, because this is C and this distance is almost twice this distance, and this is B and this distance is almost twice the distance B. Therefore, for K, L, M plane, the intercepts made are 3A, 2B, 2C. For A, B, C plane, the intercepts are shown as A, B, C. So, the law of rational indices states that the intercepts made by the plane of a crystal along three crystallographic axes are either unit intercepts or some simple whole number multiples of them. This is the statement of the law of rational indices. Right. Now, the only statement we have in the syllabus. Now, let us consider what are these Wills and Miller indices. So, like when you consider a cubic crystal, all the six planes are identical. Right. So, these six plane surfaces are called faces. It's a cubic system where a three edge lengths, length, breadth and height are equal to one another and interfacial angles are equal to 90 degrees. I said no, A is equal to B is equal to C, alpha is equal to beta is equal to gamma is equal to 90 degrees. These are the parameters, crystal parameters of a cubic crystal. So when all the six faces of a cubic crystal are identical, how to identify or designate each face in the cubic crystal or any crystal for that matter. So, in order to designate each plane in a crystal, we use a Miller indices. Okay, so these indices is outdated. We have now only Miller indices. So, Miller indices is denoted by H. So, Miller indices is nothing but a set of numbers used to designate each plane in a crystal. That's all. So, Miller indices is nothing but a set of numbers. How many numbers? 23 numbers. Denoted by HKL. So, Miller indices is nothing but the set of numbers used to designate each plane in a crystal. Right. So, how to designate or how to write Miller indices for each plane of a crystal? So, just now I showed, see the diagram where I have shown the intercepts made by the plane of a crystal along x, y, z axis are A, B, C for A, B, C plane and 3A, 2B, 2C for A, L, M, plane. Just in the diagram which was drawn earlier, I had shown A, B, C are the intercepts for the plane A, B, C and 3A, 2B and 2C are the intercepts for the plane K, L, M. Right. So, these intercepts, namely A, B, C or 3A, 2B, 2C are called as these intercepts. These indices are nothing but the intercepts made by the plane of a crystal along three crystallographic axes, namely x, y, and z axis. Right. So from these intercepts, we write Miller indices. And to make it recollect, Miller indices are nothing but a set of numbers used to designate the plane of a crystal. Right. So, now let us try to write the Miller indices for these planes having intercepts A, B and C and for another plane having intercepts 3A, 2B and 2C. Right. So, in order to write Miller indices, first you have to write intercepts. Then coefficients of intercepts. Then next one is the reciprocals. Clear? Fraction. So for now let us see. So what are the intercepts for this plane A, B, C? And what are the coefficients of intercepts? 1, 1, 1. And reciprocals of these coefficients 1 over 1, 1 over 1, 1 over 1. And we have to convert these fractions to whole numbers. So, clear fractions, so it becomes 1, 1, 1. So, there are no fractions. So, the Miller indices. For the plane ABC, having the same ABC is 1, 1, 1. So, for this plane, Miller indices is 1, 1, 1. So, this is how we write Miller indices for the plane ABC. Similarly, if we consider the second plane that was shown in the diagram, namely KLM, for which the intercepts are 3A, 2B, and 2C. Now let us try to write the Miller indices for these for this plane. So what are the coefficients of these 3, 2, 2? Then take reciprocals of these coefficients. Now, in order to write Miller indices for this plane with these intercepts, I have come up to this point. We have fractions 1 over 3, 1 over 2, and 1 over 2. Now, we have to convert these fractions into whole numbers. So, how do we convert? By multiplying with 6, so that all the 3 intercepts or these fractions will be converted to whole numbers 2, 3, 3. So, Miller indices for this plane are 2, 3, 3. This is the Miller indices for the plane KLM that was shown in the diagram. So, whenever you are to write Miller indices for any plane, you draw the table like this and follow the steps to arrive at the Miller indices. So, this is a Miller indices. So, Miller indices is nothing but the set of numbers used to designate the plane in a crystal. So, now let us see few more examples of Miller indices. Consider the intercepts minus 3a, b, and c. So, what does this minus sign indicate? All of you are familiar that in the crystallographic axis, x, y, z. So, this is the positive side, and this is negative side. This is positive quadrant, this is negative, and this is positive, and this is negative. So, we all of us are familiar. What do these plus and minus signs along the crystallographic axis indicate? So, when I write minus 3a, means the plane is meeting the x axis in this region. When I say minus 3a, the plane is somewhere meeting here, whose intercept is equal to minus 3a. Intercept along x axis a. Intercept made by the plane along y axis is b, that is standard equation, and intercept made by the plane along z axis is c, that is standard. You cannot change that. Right. So, when these are the intercepts for the plane, how to write Miller indices? So, you have minus 3a, b, and c. Now, take the coefficients of this 1, 1, and take the reciprocals of these. And last step is, in order to write the Miller indices, you have to clear this fraction. So multiply with 3. So you have 1. Minus is written as bar 1 by writing Miller indices. So intercept for this example is bar 1, 3, 3, 3. Because Miller indices is always written in the brackets. The general form of Miller indices is HKL. So, the Miller indices for this play with intercepts minus 3a, bc would be bar 1, 3, 3, 3. Okay. Let me stop here. We'll continue. Thank you.